Hi, Sean. I am behind the Mill Yard Technology Park, and this is an area that has flooded in the past. And as you can see, they are already preparing here. Lynch's Landscaping has already brought in 250 yards of sand. They've got it all set up, and they're trying to keep the water out of the building, which had flooded before, 2 feet of water inside. Now, if you take a look at the parking lot, you can see that the water is already making its way into it. All of the cars have been moved. I am told by the man from Lynch's that it moves into the parking lot about 20 feet every hour, and they have been monitoring this since yesterday. Now, I'd like to take you to another part of Nashua. At the entrance of a neighborhood, a pump is already set up to get rid of water. This is a common area that gets flooded. And if they need to, the people who live within this subdivision do have an emergency exit, but the residents are hoping that they will not have to use it. Now, inside the subdivision, Doug Huntley is monitoring the river. His backyard is right where the Merrimack and the Nashua Rivers meet, and he uses a birdhouse with markings on it to take the levels, and he says that he is taking this very seriously.
If it's 17 already, it looks like it might go a little higher than that. So we don't take anything for granted. Everybody's been notified to have their prescriptions ready in their bags if they needed to evacuate.
Now, the Nashua Public Health Department was also in the city today going door to door in many of the neighborhoods that they feel are at high risk of flooding. If somebody is home, they talk to them about some of the safety concerns and what they can do to protect their home, talking about potential evacuations. And if somebody is not home, they are just leaving a flyer in the door and making sure that people know what to do in case of an emergency. Also, Nashua has opened their EOC that is activated at this point. Reporting live in Nashua, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.